It is Dr. Sheila Tikku explaining about magnetic properties of octahedral complexes. The magnetic properties are based on the number of unpaired electrons present in the complex. Electronic configuration is also related to the magnetic properties. D1, D2 and D3 configuration in complexes of this geometry, there are 1 electron, 2 electron and 3 unpaired electrons. These electrons are present in P2G orbitals. Just as all the 5D orbitals in an isolated metal ion are covalent and no particular orbital can be assigned to an electron, the D orbital is occupied by in T2G and EG electrons. The electron of T2G orbital jumps into the EG orbital, and while jumping or while shifting, the magnetic movement of the ligand field develops, and the magnetic field or the magnetic movement is equal to the number of unpaired electrons present in the orbital. D4, D5, D6 and D7 configuration, after the electron has highly occupied each of these T2G orbitals, in D4 orbital it can occupy T2G orbital and it can also occupy EG orbital when it has the electronic configuration of T2G3 and EG1, then the compound is paramagnetic, and when it has the electronic configuration of T2G4, then it is paramagnetic equal to 2 electrons. So in the D5 configuration, and this type of magnetism and paramagnetism depends on the weak field and strong field ligands. The weak field ligands like water, fluoride, etc. are very weak, in the presence of which there is no pairing of electrons. But the strong field electrons like cyanide, nitrite, etc. are very strong, in which there is pairing of electrons. For example, when chromium H2O6 2+ and chromium cyanide 6-4- ions are compared in water molecule complex, the pairing of electrons is not done, and in without water molecule there are pairing of electrons found. These things are also given in the table below, in the table above. This table also constitutes of electronic distribution of D4, D5, D6 and D7 configurations in weak field and strong field complexes. In a similar way, metal ions having D5 configuration, example Mn+2. When Mn+2 is in D5 configuration, it has 5 unpaired electrons and it is highly paramagnetic and highly colored. But when it is in the other configuration, in which there is pairing of electrons, when the pairing of electrons happens, the number of unpaired electrons decreases to 2 and the color also becomes light. On the this type of configurations are based on the two electronic distributions, in which D6 metal ions, D7 metal ions are also shown. In the D7 state, the electrons shift to higher energy level, and this one electron has the tendency to show the paramagnetic nature or the culture of the cobalt ion. Next are the D8, D9 and D10 configurations. In the D10 configuration, D8 configuration, we have usually the square planar complexes of nickel, because it has only one orbital empty and the hybridization becomes dsp2. Next is the hybridization, nickel forms very few octahedral complexes, because in the formation of octahedral complexes it has to use the outermost d orbitals. After nickel we have the next compound which is very important, that is copper. Copper has the D9 system, and after the D9 system we have zinc, which has the D10 system. Copper has the D9 system and it makes usually square planar complexes in which no electron is going to shift. So copper is paramagnetic, equivalent to only one electron, which gives the color, blue color of the copper complexes. And in nickel we have the color when the pairing is not given, that is the ligand is weak field ligand. The last is D10 system, in which zinc is present and zinc does not has any unpaired electron. So the complexes of zinc are also colorless. If they are colored, they are due to charge transfer spectra. The calculation of Bohr magneton or the magnetic moment depends on number of unpaired electrons, that is mu is equal to under root n into n plus 2 bm. N is the number of unpaired electrons present in the complex, the table of which is given below, unpaired electrons and theoretical values of magnetic moment, that is Bohr magneton. When the number of unpaired electrons is 0, mu is 0. When number of electron is 1, mu is 1.73. when it is 2, mu is 2.83. when it is 3, mu is 3.87. when it is 4, mu is 4.90. and when it is 5, mu is 5.92.